So for this section, there's a break in the song, and then the beat comes back in, and so we're just kind of like, oh, the song's over.
Psych!
What's up, guys? My name is Jordan Orme, and I'm a professional video editor, and I edited Rain by Aitch and AJ Tracey, and let's get into the breakdown. All right, so here we go. We have a VFX paper airplane that was done by a VFX artist. So the original shot looks like this. And also on this exterior scene, all of the sky has been replaced with a pink sky, and we added clouds. Originally there weren't clouds. So this is the original shot. This is how it looks. First class flight to Alaska. The whole opening of the video concept was these guys are dancing and rapping in front of their Rolls Royce. We have this girl come up with this leather bag. She opens it up and dumps out a bunch of water onto our rappers.
The ALS Ice Bucket Challenge.
We had some real water. So there's actually a hose right here going all the way up. There's like a little shower of water coming out of the bag. Then with the VFX shot, we removed the hose and put more water coming out and added the sky. So one thing, I'm a huge fan of Sicko Mode. Sicko Mode is like one of my favorite music videos. This here with all the ice on in the boat. Shout out to Dave Myers. And this little is in Sicko Mode. Hours till I land, have me out. I was like, shoot, I'm inspired. This little reverse bouncing back effect is found in Sicko Mode. So I took that as inspiration and kind of made my own version of that. We start on this goldfish, play it backwards, play it forwards, play it backwards, play it forwards. I like to think of music videos as a dance. It's like if I was a choreographer and I was making my body move in a certain way that matches to the music, that's what I'm doing, but I'm just manipulating footage. So we're basically just creating a dance. We're choreographing the whole video, but with footage. What's going on? Why am I wet? Yeah, let's rain. I like to match the producing of the song and the beat and kind of cut to that. Yeah. And so for each of like the claps and the snares, I end up using a TV shot and just kind of match it to the beat. Me and R kid doing up money, gal on curry, neck McFlurry. When you slap your seats, that's funny. Jeans say please be a bank says bummy. I was loony before I made choose, now I'm AJ, but my AP's Bugs Bunny. The director actually sent me a video reference. It's in the Justin Timberlake and SZA video, I believe. It looks like this. So I was pulling inspiration from that video. This was shot in very slow motion. I play the slow motion part, and then I actually, instead of speed ramping within the clip, I cut the clip and speed it up really quickly. So basically think like a pose, go to a new pose and stop. Kind of like that. And also in addition to that, I add an adjustment layer with a transform position and I scaled in again. And so I zoomed out and then punched in and zoomed out again every time that we did the ramp. And that kind of goes with the snare. So it's like boom, ka. This effect right here is called lens distortion, and it looks like this. And what I did was I affected the curvature, so I had it start low, go high, and then go low again. There's kind of like a echo moment where he's like, bow, wow, wow. Let's freaking go! What's going on? Why am I wet? So this is a little match cut that I like right here. He kind of starts putting his hands up, and he has his hands up right there, both in a wide shot with them kind of centered. What's going on? Why am I wet? Yeah, let's rain. Yeah, sick of some rappers and that, but I stay doing me, never cap on a track. Alright, this is a super cool setup that I really, really enjoy. So this is the original shot. It's just him by himself in front of a pole rapping. They shot some footage. It's called a hyperlapse. All it is these girls just walking around this pole, and the shutter speed is very slow on the camera, so you get this blurring effect and the footage looks really sped up. And so what we ended up doing is layering two of these long exposure effect shots over each other and then putting them on the blend mode of lighten. And then I also had a mask that is cutting out the middle of the image, and that's where our rapper is standing. That's where H is standing. So then everything put together looks like this. What I wanted to do in this section of the song was there's kind of a break and the beat cuts out and he's just rapping. And so I wanted that to be kind of intimate and close and static. I didn't want any movement in the song. The camera's moving and then I just want to stop. No camera movement. A professor once told me contrast creates focus. And so whenever you can contrast camera movement or contrast color or contrast literally anything, it will create a change that people will notice. Remember that, everyone, take notes. Contrast creates focus.
Write that down, write that down!
I'm too young, my game's all top, but she got bust down like AJ's chain. Psycho drama, the bitch like Dave, yo, what can I say when the brain's insane? 10 for the two-tone subby and 10 for the new blue face when I rate and playing. Still come for
I ended up matching his flow in this section where the cutting matched the phrasing of his rap. So he goes, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And so there's a new shot every time.
On a rate and plane, still come for and make it rain. Turn up, stay lit, burn up, get paid. Two penguins
give. So he punches the lens and I wanted something to happen. And so what I ended up doing is I added an invert effect. And usually what invert does is it takes the colors and just flips them to the opposite side of the color wheel. And so that looks like this. But what many people don't know is there are actually a lot of different settings on invert in Premiere. And I really like the HLS setting. It kind of looks like a glitchy retro kind of deal. I wanted him to punch and then something to just kind of like spaz out on the screen for a second.
Think I got time for a side chick. No way, this not riding in my wheel.
I'm actually very proud of this effect in this part of the video. To me, it matches perfectly what the song is doing. And so basically I added the lens distortion effect and took the curvature and just turned it up for that section of the song. And as you can see, it just distorts it into the corners.
I like that. You see the edit there, watch it. I like this.
Like it matches so perfectly. It's so great. I love it.
I said, say my name. First class flight to LA as soon as I land on a paper plane. Soon touch back in the ends. 110 on the M trying to take it.
What we ended up using is called a split diopter lens. And what it is, it cuts the image in half right here. So this section of the lens is able to keep whatever's in the foreground in focus. And the background you can see is out of focus. And this section of the lens keeps whatever is in the background in focus and in the foreground out of focus. So what they're able to do, which you can't do sometimes, is have a foreground element and a background element both in focus. It's a really fun lens and it made editing this very fun because I was able to cut back and forth between the two shots. Right here he did a little like throw at the camera. And so in the next shot is that. It's like he's pushing the camera away. So he's like, go away, zoom out.
To make it rain.
So right here, we got a note from the artist that they wanted it to have more energy. So one thing that I like to do is add camera shakes in post. So what I did was I added an adjustment layer, which affects everything that comes beneath it. Added the transform effect. As you can see, I love the transform effect. Adjusted position and just made a bunch of keyframes and literally just changed the position of the camera. And so I added that on the last chorus just to give it a little extra oomph, a little extra fire.
Down this ring, right wrist and left wrist, that's ring. She said, walk on, what's going on? Why am
I added those fast cuts in a section where the hi-hat's going. So the fast cuts are on the.
Run down this ring, right wrist and left wrist, that's ring. She said, walk on, what's going on? Why am I wet? Yeah, that's ring.
So for this section, there's a break in the song. And I was like, man, what should I do for this break in the song? And so here, I was like, hey, let's just sit outside in the rain because the song is called Rain. And then the beat comes back in. And so I wanted it to just like punch right back in. So we're just kind of like, oh, the song's over. Psych. I ended up using more inverts. So we added an invert. Added the mosaic effect, just keyframed it so the blocks changed and became less. And I put that invert effect on the footage when there was a snare. Boom, cut, boom, cut, boom, cut. If you guys enjoyed this video, please check out the other videos that I have. I break down Intentions by Justin Bieber. If you want to watch through the entire video without stopping and just want to see my timeline and how I organize things, go ahead and check the description for links to those videos, and I'll see you guys in the next video.